In the App Design page, click on the Processes. Click on Design Processes. This will launch the Process Builder. The main panel in the middle is the graph area that contains the actual process diagram. Click on the Edit icon under the process name in the Navigator. This brings up the Properties dialog where you can edit the process details. Rename accordingly. Make them meaningful. Participants represent users or roles that perform a certain task. Click on the Edit button while hovering over the participant name to set its properties. Add participants into the process by clicking on the green Add button under Current Participant. Hover over existing node and choose the new node to create. Add activities, tools, and routes into the process diagram to create an approval flow. Ensure that the process has a proper start and end. To handle routing, for approval as an example, we use the diamond-shaped route. In the transition after the route, select Type Condition. Select the variable status and key in Approved. Status is the workflow variable we declared in process properties earlier. Set the other transitions type to otherwise to indicate that it is the default path to take when other conditions are not met. Click on Deploy to deploy the process to the server. JoeGet will interpret the process diagram and load the process details. In this Map Participants to Users tab, you can map each participant to specific people. Click on Add Edit Mapping to map to specific groups, users, organization chart and so on. In the second tab, we have the Map Activities to Forms. All process activities are listed here. For each activity, click on Add Edit Form to select from a list of current forms in the app. Map the Submit Request activity to our existing Travel Request form. As an example to handle an approval process, click on Create New Form to create a new approval form. Name the new form accordingly. We can make use of the existing table name. Remember to rename the section to make it meaningful. In this new form, add a subform that displays the original submitted form. Configure the subform to select the original request form. Add in radio button to have approved and rejected options. Remember to map the radio button value to the status workflow variable so that routing will work. Preview and save the form. Next, in the Map Tools to Plugins tab, you can map tools defined in the process to plugins. For each tool, click on Add Edit Plugin to select and configure a plugin. For example, we can send out email using the email tool. You can test run the process with the forms, click on the Run Process button along the top if you want to. We will now incorporate the process into the user view. Click on the name of an existing user view to launch the user view builder. Create a new menu category. Drag in list element so that we can show the list of applications. Drag a run process element into it. This menu element allows the user to start a process from the user view. Go to its properties and select the process to run. Drag an inbox element into a menu category. This menu element provides the user with an inbox to manage their assigned workflow tasks. Preview and save the user view, and you will be able to run and perform assigned tasks in the published user view. Access the app's user view from the App Center. Try to go through the travel request process. Go to inbox to attend to subsequent tasks. Thanks for watching.